everything you learned in history class was a lie. Well, maybe not everything, but they skipped the best parts. Introducing Stupiracy, where stupidity meets conspiracy. Ever heard of the Olympic marathon that nearly killed its runners? Or the time a pope put another pope's corpse on trial? Join me, Scott Rizzuto, and Tim McKernan as we uncover the most outrageous historical moments and mind-blowing conspiracies you won't believe actually happened. Tune in to Stupiracy for your weekly dose of historical absurdity. Available wherever you get your podcasts. Remember, history is dumb, but laughing at it is smart.
Damn, he's good though, isn't he? Oof.
Look at this baby. Couldn't get sick with this mask if you wanted to.
Darn it, I forgot to tweet that.
Look at this baby.
It's looking very official, Dr. Ricey.
You could sleep on these sheets, man. That'd be great.
Nothing's getting through that.
What's going on, man?
Well, the Los Angeles Clippers got a guard named Lou Williams.
Lou, yeah, he's kind of an odd character.
He was allowed to leave the bubble.
For Dad's funeral, right?
For Dad's funeral, and then he was...
How many times his dad died, by the way?
I don't know, about six or seven, probably. Right.
Weeks in a row.
Grandma.
Well, who died more, Lou Williams' dad or Percy Harvin's grandma?
Well, can we finish the story?
Yes. Yeah, go ahead.
They found him in a strip club.
Yes,
he violated the quarantine rules.
They had video in the strip club, but he was there for the wings.
Well, he wanted to just get the chicken.
He went there for food. Yep. Whenever I want a basket of chicken wings, I call up the Seville and say, I'm
quality
on my way,
stuff.
Baby. Yeah, deja vu. Do they have chicken wings? I don't
know. He went to the Magic City Strip Club in Atlanta.
God almighty.
Would you go to any strip club that had city in it, Joe?
Nope.
I know you won't do Rib City or Steak City, but how about Magic City Strip Club?
Here's the deal with the Miami has probably has the youngest roster of players in baseball.
Mm-hmm.
And they were, before they went to play an exhibition game against Atlanta last week, they were, and then head on to Philadelphia, they were training for 3 weeks in Miami, right?
Mm-hmm.
And a lot of the fellas who were first identified appeared to be perhaps from Caribbean nations, okay?
Sure.
It sounded like they had a Hispanic quality to them. And they were told, just like they were here, I'm sure, now be careful when you don't go out. You know, go to the grocery store if you have to.
Essentials.
But don't get in big crowds. And I just have a hunch that the dance clubs in Miami on the beach there might have caused some of the fellas to say, yeah, maybe I'll go over there just for one.
You mean just
two.
Because they've upped
hour
their game on their wings, right?
Yeah. So, here's the problem. Baseball's biggest problem, I don't think. Now, the Miami's trying to say this occurred after they left, right? That these guys in Philadelphia. The trouble is they trusted these guys for 3 weeks.
Yeah.
They didn't monitor them. They said, go home, be with your family, don't go out. Don't go to
They use the honor
clubs.
System.
They use the
Locks
honor
are for
system.
Honest people.
No, they used the line from Animal House where hey, screwed up, man. You trusted us.
Yeah. Didn't say screwed up, but it was close. Yeah.
Yeah,
I said that to Flounder after they ruined his brother's car.
Yeah.
Yeah, Otter, I've used that on occasion. Yeah, that's
Pat,
true.
Are you pessimistic that they'll... I'm pessimistic that they'll be able to complete the 60-game season.
Well, I am too, because I can see the political... You know, David Price is a big wussy. He's not playing for the Dodgers this year, and he's on Twitter saying, this shows they have no concern about the players' baseball. Because he's not playing, he doesn't want anybody to be playing, right?
Right.
He's the conscience of America. He's also the guy that everybody in Boston hated because he took on Eckersley for some criticism and other idiotic things he's done. Well, who was it that the...
it was Eckersley.
Yeah, but then he also had some...
Oh, it was Shaughnessy, I think. Didn't he get into it with Shaughnessy?
No, a slur of somebody. But I think that baseball has got to realize that when they started up, stuff like this was going to happen. They can't, you know, if some team getting a bunch of cases was going to cause you to call it off, then why did you even bother to start?
So. Right, and apparently they're getting tested whenever they want to, and it's obvious they're going to find more positive testing. Then what are they going to do?
Just like President Trump, don't test anymore, and then you have less cases.
Well, if five twins test positive tomorrow, then Chicago would have to shut down because they're the last team the Twins play.
Yes, that's the even though they say it's highly, we don't know if any of the Phillies have tested positive because they played the Marlins. But the Yankees, I think the main reason they're not playing Philadelphia tonight is the Yankees want to make sure that visitors' clubhouse is spick and span. You ever watch one of these movies about the people that clean up crime scenes?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, which is a tough job, but well-paid.
30 miles away, I'll be there in 5 minutes.
Yeah, and, you know, you got to get a few of those guys in there to clean up the bugs, I think, in that locker room. But I think you just, you know, you got to hang. Here's the deal. You cannot punish a team for not being able to play those games. You're going to just have to go to you can't say everybody's got to play 60. If somebody loses six games, you just got to go to winning percentage to have your playoffs. I doubt if they'll make it through the fall. Where's the fall surge, by the way?
Well, it ain't fall yet.
If we get the fall surge after this surge, nobody's playing anything. So. Mm-hmm. Anyway, I don't know.
By the way, your guy Lavelle just tweeted out, Nelson Cruz is the American League Player of the Week.
Well, I would hope so, even though it was a short week.
It was three games.
How many RBIs?
10 RBIs.
10 RBIs. That's a good start for a 40-year-old gentleman.
Wow.
You throw in the fact that it was 93 degrees yesterday. In what I like to call Comiskey, even though they've gone through nine different names.
The ring of guaranteed rate field?
That ball was flying, too, man.
It really was. As
you get that heat and humidity, that ball goes.
How about seeing those crowds when they are superimposed, there's a fly ball or a home run or whatever? And
boy, struggling with fanless baseball.
I'm struggling with the noise. Yeah. Sometimes the noise is louder than it is in the regular game. You know, here's the deal. If you're going to do that and a guy from the home team comes in and, like, gives up two home runs in a row, we should have some booing, too,
some
right?
Heckling,
Let's get some booing, too.
So if Zach Littell's performance on Saturday had been at Target Field, we could have really come down on him.
What was that?
That was pure slop is what that
was. Wow, man. But here's my theory. They should let eight drunks in the ballpark.
Social distancing.
Just so you hear somebody say something stupid.
And just have them. And the only requirement is you yell repetitive nonsense that really has no context with the game.
Get in the hole. Yeah, get in the hole. Right?
I'll raise every one of them should be mic'd up, too.
Yes, right. And you scatter them all around, and they just yell. They wouldn't even have, if they would turn off all the other noise. You could hear them. It's like those rainout. You know, there's nothing better. Yeah. There's nothing better than the 2.5 hour rainout when the game is resumed at 11:30 p.m.
Yep.
And there's 14 drunken louts left screaming incessantly and to no end.
Well, in fact, Joe, on July 23rd, the mayor himself tweeted, "Fanless baseball is not working for me. I need to hear somebody yell something stupid," to which I retweeted, "What time do you want me to come over?"
Reavers could be a candidate.
Oh, get me 7 IPAs and I got you covered, baby.
That's right.
And a ride home.
Hey, Pat.
Yes.
Who's the Vikings trainer and chief officer for COVID? He's now got COVID. What does that mean?
Eric Sugarman, did you see that?
Yeah.
So about 3 days ago, three, 4 days ago, we had a piece on their fight against COVID in the Star Tribune. Mm-hmm. And we were praising Eric as the point man who was coming up with all the methods to keep from getting the COVID.
Mm-hmm.
They forgot to tell the COVID.
Ah.
You know.
Yeah.
Is that irony?
Yeah, I don't know.
When do they start camp? This week?
The rookies are there tomorrow, right? I think the rookies are supposed to be there tomorrow, but it's not. It's going to be like a week of running around and running drills. And if baseball can't work, this can't work.
Right.
Who's going to be the guy that goes
They already canceled the exhibition season?
Yes, they did.
Yeah, they did. Yeah. But who's going to be the guy that walks up to Zim and says, Zim, put on your mask?
Yes, right. Yeah.
Well, how does it work driving by the Vikings complex? They have that whole – I know they're not letting people come in to watch training camp or the rookies – but can people stay at that hotel?
I don't know. Is that where the team's staying?
I have no idea. I'm not sure if... I mean, I suppose if you want to book a hotel, you could probably stay there. But they're just not allowing you access to their...
I don't think... you know, they may be just letting the players there or something. I don't think hotel rooms are in great demand right now. So you can...
True.
You know.
But he builds that big hotel at Viking Lakes, and if it's empty, he's...
I know some people who were investors in that who are probably not getting their return on their money right now.
Ooh, yikes.
So, anywho, who knows? But Nelson Cruz, Joe... 40 years old. We were looking up Molly today. Molly was 39 when he joined the Twins and had that phenomenal year.
Yep.
And 40-year-old hitters are, I mean, it's amazing they can still get the bat and the ball.
I'm just watching a video now of who's the manager that came out to argue with the ump, but first they stopped and put all their...
That was a guy that just... Derek Shelton left the Twins.
Put their masks on.
Third game. He came out, and that, by the way, that Jordan Baker is a red ass. The umpire. He loves to throw. Well, somebody threw Lovello out too, right?
Did he? I missed that.
Arizona
but they pause politely to adjust their mask. Yes. Then they go at it. What do you think? How do you think Earl Weaver would handle it?
Earl, put your mask on and then call me every filthy name.
Right.
Would Earl have the hole in the side of the mask for the heater?
How about Bernsey talking about Schnelker with a mask on? That would have been great. that's Bernsey without a mask.
Right.
You put the mask on.
It would be something.
Yeah, well, being Bernsey, it would be a terribly ill-fitting mask.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it'd be slipping off because he's so skinny and he just doesn't have
that. Are there plans to allow NFL teams to have fans in the stands?
They have not yet announced that they won't, right?
Well, I do know that the Vikings have officially offered season ticket holders the right to opt out for the season so they can either get their money back or they can forward whatever they've paid towards 2021.
Which would be the Vikings' preference.
Correct.
2020.
But the smart season ticket holders are going to say, I want my money back.
Yes.
Well,
yes.
Okay, help me understand something. The governor's latest order is the mask will be worn.
Indoors.
Indoors.
Yes.
Until there's a dramatic decrease in infections, not just a drop, a dramatic decrease, or until special authority runs out that he keeps giving himself and they keep approving. Okay, my question is, how do we know we're not going to be sitting here next summer saying the exact same thing?
No, we don't. So come on. Come on, Mayo Clinic. Let's see if live up to your reputation here. Oxford University, let's go.
Yeah.
Although, even then, it's going to be hard. How many people in the world?
Quite a few, Pat.
Yeah, it's going to be hard to get all those vaccines out there, right?
Yeah.
But
yeah.
You know one thing? Having seen us work together on the toilet paper crisis, I'm sure that we'll be backing off and letting those most in need to get the vaccines first, right?
There was some guy that put up a photo of discount toilet paper and his garage was full of it.
I got cheap stuff from the early years still sitting in there.
Yep.
Sitting in there. I don't know what I'm going to do with it. I'll probably have to throw it away.
No.
It doesn't expire.
Yeah, but it's cheap stuff.
Oh, so what?
You got a tender rear end like mine. You can't be using that cheap stuff. You want Charmin's double soft.
Here we go. We're one and done, baby. One and done.
That's right.
Oh, God, help me.
That's right. It is amazing what... It is amazing we don't care about it.
No.
It's incredible. But well,
one lady at Aldi early on was rumored to have thrown herself on top of the 7 cases of toilet paper.
You're
saying,
kidding
this
me.
Is all mine. This is before they did the limitations.
Yes.
Yeah, I was. I remember. I don't remember what store it
we
was.
We are
I heard
losing
the story.
Our minds.
Ryan, my stepson, was at in the first week, and there was like, he was sitting there, and there was like 6 packages in front of them, and he was standing politely behind the guy, and the guy took all 6.
Oh.
And Ryan says, "Really?" So the guy gave him one, like Jesse, better than Jesse. You think Jesse had enough toilet paper?
Yeah, Rook. You could just use your hand like they did in the olden days. Just don't say hi to anybody. When you give somebody a salutation, make sure it's just vocal.
Yeah, he wouldn't have slipped your roll. And, wouldn't have slipped your roll.
Can you help tell you the truck was coming tomorrow.
Yeah, help me put the rest of this underneath because there ain't no more room in the Suburban.
Would
that scrap it,
Mr. Governor? Would that same rule apply then, as Patrick noted, with the vaccine? Who's getting it first?
I'm going to be in line first. It's like Joe said with the turkey leg. If you're stuck on the island with me and a turkey leg is available, you ain't getting none. You know
where is he?
He's off the grid, man.
Is he? He is. Oh, really
Pat,
off
you
got to
follow him on Twitter. He's a hoot.
Is he
on Who's Twitter?
He yeah. hates Trump, right? But he hates everybody else.
He pretty
too.
Much hates everybody.
Yeah.
Hey, Pat, I know if you don't follow me on Twitter, but you'd be very entertained. I'm very creative.
He is at GovJVentura on Twitter.
He's no longer the Gov. Let's drop that.
Once the Gov, always the Gov.
All right.
That's its privilege.
1 hour ago, he tweeted about Homeland Security, custom agents, the Border Patrol, and other things called hashtag Monday Thoughts.
Uh-huh. Should just be listed under a black helicopter.
Hey, is the trumpeter going to go see John Lewis's casket? Has he been there
I haven't
there
seen
yet?
Him appear yet. I've been monitoring.
Has he ever said a word about Lewis?
Yes. Oh, he must have said something, didn't he? I mean, he's getting soft in his old age. Now he's pro-mask.
Reeves, I think you could find it if you want. J.L. Calvin explaining why he's not going to throw out the first pitch at a Vikings Yankees game.
Why did that happen? I thought he was all set.
Well,
up.
You can hear the explanation.
The kneeling, I'll bet you.
Let's see. I'm trying to find it.
Oh,
but
that's right. That was the kneeling must be what's keeping him away, huh?
Could
not,
be.
I'm not sure.
Fake news. Just got a question right. No, I will not be throwing out the first pitch on August 15th at the great Yankee Stadium, one of our great places for sports. And, because we're going to be doing very strong meetings. We're having strong meetings on coronavirus, which is so important. Nobody knew, even a month ago, nobody knew how tough this thing was. Everybody thought it was going to fade away. And it turns out it is fading away. But not everywhere. There's some places, places that love Trump, that vote for Trump, that might vote for Mountain Dew and bath salts that were on the ballot against Trump, but because they're not, they love Trump. And we've got to protect these great Americans. Okay, so I won't be throwing out the pitch. Mike, you were looking for, you like to catch. He prefers to catch, but, in our great sports, you got to have both. You got to have a pitch and a catch.
Yep.
And, it's tough because baseball is one of our great, they call it a pastime because, it takes a lot of time and, the time passes and it becomes sort of a past time. A lot of people don't know that, but it's one of our great things. And you can have snacks, hot dogs, right, Mike? Hot dogs, Cracker Jacks, And other things. You have other things. Have I ever taken Barton? Who's Barton? No, I don't. I don't go to games with kids I don't know. But we have to fight the coronavirus first, and then we'll get back. We'll get back to sports so fast your head will spin.
Okay. Wow. Say, I gotta say, I finally thought why he's not going though because of the kneeling, right?
I don't know.
Probably
is
why.
That probably why?
Yeah.
We covered that on the opening day, though.
This would be a perfect time for him to go because he can't be booed.
Oh yeah, he wouldn't. He wouldn't be. New York wouldn't be a good place for him to come out of hiding. That wouldn't be good.
Probably not.
Pat, I said earlier on this on GL today that if the city councils in the American cities don't get a handle on this riotous behavior, I got to think sports are in trouble.
Oh, you're not. That's everybody's talking about the virus, but What if they decide, hey, there's a ball game down there today. Let's go down there and raise hell.
Look at this week's weather, you know. This would be a perfect week to take the fam to a ball game, but who would feel safe doing so?
Yeah. Yeah, well, there's no doubt about it.
It's a great week.
You're right. And Twins, I mean, that's as urban as it gets, basically, that ballpark, right?
Right,
and,
right.
And we got you. I do support the graffiti on the biking building, I'm in favor of that. just a little graffiti, that's fine. I don't think, especially the Vikings, which you agitate them. So I support that. Little graffiti, I don't.
And was it coaching advice or was it anything that having to do with don't kneel at halftime or?
But Pat, it'd be more a case of teams just not playing. There's no place to move really. Every big city in the country is experiencing similar problems. It's not like Ziggy could say, "Well, I'm going to go to." Portland. Well, A, you're not going to go to Portland, and B, is Portland even big enough? I guess what I'm trying to say is if they don't get a handle on this, the sports will just implode. They won't be able to move a team to a better city because all the cities are in the same boat.
Yeah, it will, like the late 60s, it'll kind of drift away eventually. In 2-3 years, the civil unrest, and we'll have a peace for a while. But you're right, 2021, you throw in the virus and the ongoing problems in the streets, it's hard to make big plans for next season, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. It really is.
Yeah, you're right about that. Boy, luckily for us, we don't have much money invested in stadiums in this state.
Aren't we lucky? Isn't we fortunate?
I think the city of Minneapolis, only when you include interest, is on the hook for about $600 million for the U.S. Bank Stadium. And, of course, the Hennepin County was paying off Target Field at a sprightly pace until this happened.
Now they got nothing.
Well, I don't know, but obviously they don't have the surplus they've been running because it's, what, an eighth of a cent on commerce in Hennepin County.
We asked this, I think it was last week, but, have the Twins voiced publicly their reluctance to opening up their gates? And I remember
they're trying not to mention. They're trying not to tell people.
Okay.
Yeah, they're gonna. It happened in Chicago. So, of course, that ballpark's in a tough neighborhood. So
the South Side. Oh yeah.
Yeah. So it happened in Chicago. I think you just don't want to. The last thing you want to do is say, "Now, please." Please, we're friendly, peace-loving people. Don't come down here and raise hell. Don't say that. So we tore down Calvin's statue already. Please stay away.
Right.
Yeah. Yeah. I don't see a good ending here. I just don't see a good ending.
Yeah. Well, remember that when the riots were in Detroit, probably don't remember this, but the Twins were in town to play the Tigers.
I wasn't there.
They had them play afternoon games.
Right.
Tigers were good then, and hoping that people would stay home and watch the ball game instead of go out and burn stuff. But they played afternoon games. They didn't play night
games. And when was this?
67.
67, I believe, yeah, when Detroit was burning. Yeah. Nice thing about that riot in Detroit, you can only see half of the damage still today.
4 years later.
Yeah, 50 years later. We're getting around to it here. We'll fix it one of these times. Wow. So. Unreal.
Well, things aren't getting cleaned up here very quickly.
No, I suppose you want to make sure they're done before you fix anything, right? I have not driven down Lake Street to check her out.
Hello?
Crazy. How in the hell did you know that?
Same. Where were we?
Hey, you mentioned Detroit, and earlier today, Pat and I were talking about Alex Avila, the new Twins backup catcher, and you guys know what one of my favorite anecdotes about Alex Avila is, or one of my favorite anecdotes in baseball. One of the only guys to be traded by his old man.
Yes, he was.
Al
got rid of him. Now,
what an honor.
Clark Griffith did trade Joe Cronin, who was married to his niece, Mildred, He traded him.
I didn't know
from
that.
From the Washington Senators, yes. And that Calvin's sister.
Okay.
He traded Calvin's sister's husband, Joe Cronin, the Hall of Famer.
You don't hear the name Mildred much anymore.
No. Mildred, she was, I think, the oldest and outlasted them all.
Yep.
And she was great.
She had good genes.
She was a great gal. And Joe was a Hall of Fame baseball player. And of the Griffiths I met,
yep,
Mildred was by far the best looking. So Joe, she was easy to romance. I knew her when she was 60, and she still looked good. So Mildred was supposed to be a great gal. Yes.
Did she ever live here?
No. Joe was the president of the American League when the Twins moved here.
Right.
So that was a pretty good connection. Hmm. There's a famous story about Charlie Johnson. You knew Charlie.
Yeah.
Yeah. And Charlie was the sports editor of both the Star and the Tribune. He was Sid's boss even when Sid was the Tribune sports editor. And Charlie had a tendency to have a few cocktails and get mean. Mm-hmm. When he got mean, he would, he was the head of the state. This is how different thing was. The sports center was the head of the stadium task force.
Wow. Yep.
Trying to
yep.
get Major League Baseball. But there's a famous story of him. They're having the all-star game meeting. Mm-hmm. And the Minneapolis, St. Paul are always there competing with each other to try to get Major League team, and the rumors are hot and heavy that the Senators are going to move to Minnesota. And apparently Charlie gets on the elevator with Joe Cronin, and he's drunk, and he starts telling Joe how we don't want his brother. We don't want his, what would he have been? His in-law. His
brother-in-law?
Brother-in-law. Okay. We don't want your BS brother-in-law's lousy team. They're a terrible team. And Charlie starts abusing Calvin about not wanting the team. And they, Jerry Moore and the rest of the fellas on the committee had to make peace with Joe. We do want you. Don't pay any don't pay any attention to Charlie when he's been drinking.
Right. Don't pay any attention to the head of our task force.
Greatest newspapering hit I ever had in my life. I'm a copy boy. 1965. Van Brocklin quits. Mm-hmm. Van Brocklin quits after the fourth game of the season. Because they're sixth game. I've taken this team as far as I can. I think they lost to Detroit. Charlie and Sid are standing. I'm sitting there doing something, and I'm about 8 feet away from these guys, and they are calling Van Brocklin every filthy name known to mankind. They both hate him. And then they both wrote columns the next day begging him to come back. And I said, if I ever get the chance, I ain't going to do that.
Yeah. And you haven't.
I don't know how long I'll last, but if I think a guy's a jackass, I might ignore it. But I'm certainly not going to beg him to come back after he quit. But they both suspected that he would change his mind, which he did a couple of days later.
Yeah.
And then he lasted one more year, that year in 66. And then he got in his feud with Tarkington. And
that was it.
That was great times, though, to be in the I wasn't in the business, but 66, Tarkington wrote a letter. Who did he write the letter to? Open letter to fans, Joe? Saying he wanted to be traded. He couldn't play for Van Brocklin anymore.
It
might have been to the fans. And then Van Brocklin quit, and then they tried.
Not that old. I was still in high school.
I know. But anyway,
And then what?
Then Van Brocklin quit, and then Tarkington said, I still want to be traded. So
okay.
They thought.
Then he went to the Giants.
Went to the Giants for 5 years. The greatest thing ever happened to Vikings because they got absolute, just a bouquet of great players out of that trade. So He was a miserable little lout, though, Francis.
Francis Asbury Tarkington.
I didn't deal with him that much. You dealt with him more than I did.
I had to deal with him a lot, yeah.
He is. You know, it was Klobuchar and Sid. They just had a bloody battle to see who could kiss his ass the hardest, man. It was unbelievable.
One time I was in the airport waiting to leave to cover a game. Sid just, I must have written another column, ripping the dome, the preparation to build a dome. And Sid just lit me up in the airport waiting room, waiting area, to the point where it was so bad, even Tarkenton stepped in and defended me.
You guys were flying on the same plane back then, huh?
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Unreal. Yeah. But, yeah, that had to be bad if Sid was that bad. But
he was so bad, even Tarkenton came to my defense, he was not a fan of me.
No, well, he's...
You had some thoughts on the old dome, did you, Mayor?
I did. Yeah.
Fran was a fan of Fran. That's who he was a fan of.
Yeah. So I'm curious, you were talking about when the Senators moved here, why did they pick Bloomington and not one of the downtowns?
Well, they had both St. Paul and Minneapolis had stadiums. The Met Stadium was built like County Stadium with the intention of being expanded if they could get a club.
Okay.
And St. Paul was their rival, and they built a stadium too. Midway, the original Midway, not the dump that you all saw later.
Right.
And that also was going to be expandable. And there was a St. Paul task force and a Minneapolis task force. Back then, there was no working together.
No.
But I think Bloomington was chosen by the Minneapolis people as though it would be a neutral site and get the St. Paul people to sign on. And eventually that happened.
Okay.
And then Midway Stadium sat there for years. And Midway Stadium was built for the hope of Major League Baseball, but for the American Association team, the St. Paul Saints, ended up being a home for St. Agnes football. Right? Right.
Well, it was also...
Biking practice.
Hill played a lot of games there.
Yeah.
High schools.
And the Vikings practiced there before the... until the Twins season ended, and then they moved to Met Stadiums.
Right.
So the Vikings would come from Mankato and move all their crap over to Midway.
Wow.
And I think it was probably at Midway where you cost them the draft choice, wasn't it?
No, that was out at the
Mets.
At the facility?
Yeah.
He worked out, and thanks a lot.
But it's unbelievable, fella. We went and you'd show up at practice, you go stand on a field about 8 feet away from everybody and talk to him when they walked by. It was at
Midway where Jim Marshall threw a football at my head. And I can, to this day, I can hear it whistling past. It would have killed me if it hit me. I can still hear it whistling past my ear, just like a rocket.
I went out to see him, and they wanted some stuff before the Super Bowl. And, God, I talked to him for 2.5 hours. He was great.
Yeah.
It was sat there. But he got the bad wheels, man.
Yeah.
When you play more games in a row than any position player ever, you get the bad wheels.
You are beat up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But he was a different guy. Plus, half of his injuries are from various accidents that he was in. What was the hang glider he damn near killed himself?
Oh, yeah, the motorized hang glider?
In Bloomington, yeah. In Bloomington, he ran into a building.
How you doing in the game of floss?
You know what? It's been a good week.
Really? It's good.
Now, only one real... She really had to work hard this week because we had some friends over Friday.
Oh.
And she was sitting there and she had a clear glass.
Uh-oh.
And I said, you know, it was a hot, steamy day Friday. And I said, are you having a vodka, dear? Mm-hmm. And she said, when's the last time I had a vodka? And she gave me hell on it. Like, 2 days later, she's still bringing up, maybe I'll go down and have a vodka. And I said, boy, you're working really hard. You're working working really hard for a resentment this week. You know, usually you have better material.
Right. Yeah. I can provide you with top drawer material.
Yes. Usually you don't have to go to one innocent remark about whether you were having a vodka or not. And then I said, she said, when did you see me drink vodka? I said, well, you used to have a jug down in Florida in the drawer. There was a jug of vodka.
Jug.
She said, yeah, and then your friend Lavelle drank it.
Oh, so Lavelle participated in the game.
I thought it was going to be the Malkowskis when they were down there.
So now she's So now Lavelle's on her. Lavelle entered the game of flaws.
Why did that come up, by the way, when Rook, you had unopened packages? Was it the home? Was that what came up last week? Because Rook wasn't on Sports Talk last week.
No, that was 2 weeks ago, I think.
Oh, because
when he had all the unopened.
Well, because you said last week you had said that you went into the room and there was all this stuff that hadn't been opened yet, Patrick.
Where?
At the Golden Valley estate.
Oh, at the Golden
Valley. Oh, you were cleaning something and you found packages unopened.
Stacks of
all kinds of stuff.
You had some excess.
Important purchase items.
The VCR Plus.
VCR Plus.
That's what it was.
Somebody sent me an email wanting to buy it.
Really?
I said, I threw it away 5 years ago. What the hell are you talking about?
It didn't work. It just needed batteries.
What was the white thing? The white, like, flip top?
CD player?
Toilet seat?
Might have been some kind of
toilet seat.
I don't know, if we hit the button
and it opens up, it would have been in all shapes and sizes.
Yeah, maybe we did that one too.
That was never used either. The video disc? It wasn't like a big.
I didn't see a disc there. No, okay. I don't know. My best was when we had the garage sale, Joe.
Yeah.
I took all these CDs out there and sold them for like 50 cents a piece. Everybody's coming back. There's no CD in here. All you're doing is selling me the
cases.
Oh, I said, well, there's got to be a handful of those someplace, you know.
Yeah.
They were getting the cases for them. I got hundreds of them.
Just hit eject and about five of them come out.
Oh, God. Yes.
Oh, Lord.
I miss the... The eight tracks, though, man, those were great.
I would love to have a front row seat between you and the DA organizing a garage sale over the weekend.
I did nothing to help. I said, "You want to sell some of these CDs?" No, I complained bitterly about it. Because they're all crooks.
Yeah,
they all want to make a deal. They all want to, you know, they all want to pay ahead.
This is a dollar, and I want to give you 50
we
cents.
Put a price on it. Take it or leave it. Get the hell out of here.
We had
of course,
one.
If you wait long enough, if you wait till like 5 o'clock Sunday at a racing garage sale, you can take what you want.
Just put it all out.
We don't want to put this crap back, okay? Take whatever you want.
At one of our garage sales, McLaren was approached. Somebody pulled something out of the quarter box, 25 cents. Will you take half for this? She just kind of stared back and like, it's 25. You can't, 12 and a half cents. It's just, that's what people do, though. It's a kids.
I thought somebody made you, I thought you were going to say somebody made you an offer for McLaren. We'll give you 50.
What do you got? Let me think what you got.
You wanted 100, we'll give you 25.
She's got a lot of attitude.
Are these things, are garage sales even allowed right now? Or the walls put a damper on those?
We had one in our neighborhood the other day. I saw
South
St.
Paul,
so.
Too. They had a couple. A tool sale, which is really hard to resist if you're a guy.
Yeah.
If somebody's getting rid of all the tools,
you're outside, Joe, so you can socially distance outside. As long as you got your mask on, I think you'd be all right.
I guess.
Are you guys gonna have one?
I know where you can get some tools.
Suits, you got some
I
stuff.
I know where you can get tools. New tools. Never been used.
Right. Yep.
Big red box down there.
That, or if you fly down to Fort Myers at his estate, I can get you a ladder that's brand new. I can get you a bucket, 5 gallon bucket, drill bit, drill socket, wrench, everything still in the packaging.
Say, I went to my favorite Chinese joint for takeout.
Yeah.
A week ago, and they now have it set up at the door with a table.
Social distancing, so nobody can come in.
So I can't buy the $2 pail. They always got pail, $2. Selling some pail that used to have. Talk about cheap.
Right.
You know,
right.
We're selling a pail. Hey, you know, instead of saying, hey, you want a pail? You know, we're going to get $2 for a pail.
They're selling you the pail that Pickles came in.
Yeah, right. That's basically they're selling the pail. Washed out the pail. $2.
Snuffies did that, Rook.
Snuffies would sell the
pail. They'd sell you a pail. You get a pail.
Is Snuffy still with us?
I don't know. It's not. I believe there still may be one on Lexington in Roseville off of Larpenteur in Lexington, but the one on St. Clair closed down. St. Clair and Cleveland, before the COVID? It was prior to, yeah. They've renovated it, and now it's a karate store.
Ravers, I got a shocker for you.
Okay.
I was in Cologne yesterday. You know, they had two bars downtown. One closed 15 years ago. The other, the bar, Cologne doesn't have a downtown bar. They got a couple out in the road.
Okay.
town like that, town ball team, no bar downtown.
That's
how is that
okay.
possible?
That is
how
not is okay.
Right.
Good German town like
that. How are
that?
The Kurds, by the way?
Oh, they were good.
The Cologne Hollanders boys are famous
well,
for
no.
their cheese
Craig
curd.
Craig Peksa, manager, curd maker.
Yep.
And he worked for years to get the right coating on it.
Ooh.
It's not heavy, not greasy.
Yeah.
Very tasty, very good.
Oh. And are you saddened, Pat, that we won't be doing the fair?
No, but I could
okay.
use a nice Prano Pop.
Yeah. Well, you can get them. They're going to have a food parade.
So
I do.
What is that going to be, like 2 days, some weekend or a
couple
what?
Of weekends.
3 weekends.
And
three
we're
weekends.
Supposed to stay in our cars?
Yep.
And it should be a 1 to 2 hour experience.
You know how long that line will be?
I will be there 5 minutes. I want my cheese curds.
I want my Gizmo. Is she going to come
Gizmo's
up from
not
Iowa?
Make
she
it.
Won't come up from Iowa,
no.
probably.
No.
Yeah, that line's going to be down Snelling towards the airport. That's
oh,
how
yeah.
long that line's
yeah,
going to be.
It's going to be unreal. I wonder if I can call her and have her mail me. Can she have her mail me a gizmo?
I bet she could put one together.
Send them to up in a
is
FedEx
Iowa
box.
Having their state fair?
I don't
no,
think so.
I don't think so.
I think
so.
Probably not many of them are having
no.
So.
Well, the sad thing is when I had my wax hand place up there in Family Fun Park, the guy next to me lives in Roseville. He had the marionettes. The little puppet things, and that's all he did.
Yeah.
He'd go to Texas, New Mexico, Oklahoma, Minnesota, Wisconsin. He's got nothing.
Joe,
Omar.
I got to ask you a question.
Mm-hmm.
What is your quality of your mask? Do you have a, like, did the CP sew you up a really fine mask?
She's the pandemic's Betsy Ross.
And so you have one that probably has no trouble covering nose and mouth, huh?
Pat, there's not a day that goes by without large deliveries of various new experimental polypropylene cloths and batik cotton.
Right. Oh, so the UPS guy is never gets past you, huh?
No, we got masks. We got masks. But Reaver's mother
yep.
is making GL masks, and
oh,
she's
wow.
going to make me one.
Yep, she made a couple, and I was going to bring one in for Rook, and I must have left it on my kitchen counter.
Can't imagine
you
forgot.
Reavers denies that his mother had anything to do with those masks in Marshall, Minnesota.
Oh,
so
my God. Oh, the nuts.
I also got the pull-up thing, though, that sleeve you put around your neck.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
And then you just pull it up if you need a mask. Boom, there it is.
What? Do that again. Tell me
I
what.
I got a sleeve I put over
sleeve.
My head.
Sleeve
yeah.
over your head.
It sits around your neck, keeps
so you
cool.
look like a brother. Kind of like a
do-rag kind
yeah,
of.
Yeah, a do-raggy deal.
But you pull it over
okay.
your neck.
Then you pull it up over your nose and mouth if you need a mask.
Wow, and this would you would use this when you're going to the gas station?
I don't use that one at the gas station, mm-hmm. even though I have pay inside privileges, which
yeah.
I've learned to enjoy are you, over the years.
Are you, so you're still going inside? Yeah.
To pay, hell yes. I don't pay at the pump.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know how. The no, we got a lot of masks. We got a lot of masks.
On one of my masks, what I've done, just a little sense of humor, mask sense of humor, I cut a little slit right in the front so I can still go, yeah.
Oh my God.
It's shocking. The shock value is high.
You know, a lot of people do not enjoy
right
a lot of people yeah. do not enjoy mask humor.
No, we don't. No, we're not.
So you cannot have, you cannot, you know, we all feel bad when people die, but we can still have a mask joke now and again,
sure,
can't
once
we?
In a while.
When
yeah.
people sneeze, though, you do see people just go, what? Their head just turns around and go, what do you got?
Mm-hmm. I just refuse to make it. I made a conscientious decision to draw no conclusions if you're wearing a mask alone in your car. I find it curious.
Well, alone in the car, that still bothers me.
Yeah.
But, yeah, and you know what bothers me?
Here we go.
Manager and coach is wearing the mask in the dugout, but the player's not.
Right.
Why is that?
I have no idea.
Because we're not wearing a mask does me no good, right?
Right.
I'm helping you.
Correct.
I'm being a patriotic American.
You are not spreading the coronavirus if you have it, by chance.
But it does me no good to prevent it from coming into my lungs wherever it comes from.
Okay.
Does it come into my... Where does it come in?
Your nose.
Always the nose?
That's what I just read.
Or the mouth. Can it come in through
nose
the mouth?
Nose or mouth. Yep.
Well, it can come in both then. How about lower openings? Can
nope,
it come in
no,
there?
No, you're
you gotta
safe.
Be pretty, you got to be
you're
wide
pretty
open.
Good there. You're pretty good.
Unless you're at a strip club, you know, I mean, you don't know what.
Well, and I think it's killed by the one-ply toilet paper you were speaking of earlier.
Oh, no, really? Yeah.
What is, referencing earlier in the show, what is mask etiquette at the strip club? Are you, do you have that?
I said.
Or do you need my new one?
I said. This whole thing takes all the fun out of the lap dance.
Yeah,
the
it really
6 feet.
Does.
The 6 feet.
Or wait a minute. What? Could, you know, the average, like let's just use a scale, an arbitrary scale. Right. Could the level 2 dancer put the mask on and the guy's thinking it's a level 10?
Right.
So she's going to make a bit more money.
Ah! Right. And then
leave it on.
I'll give you $5 if you take that mask off.
He says this with the mask on. Something about you seems a little different. Shotzi.
I forget who did it, but it might have been, I don't know if it was Ravel or somebody, but was rating, started the thread of rating strip club food around the country because of Lou Williams.
That's clever.
Did you watch John Mulaney yet?
No.
I told you to watch him last week, the comedian.
Oh.
He does pretty good stuff. 2018-2015. His bit about he's not horribly political, but he explains his euphemism for Trump is there's a horse in the hospital. And everybody's talking about this horse in the hospital. And then he says, we haven't heard the horse for a while. And we're thinking, you think maybe the horse is settled down now? And he says, then you hear those hoofbeats. He said, there's the horse again. It's pretty good because it's not, you know, nasty
top,
political.
Yeah. It's not
crazy.
Joy Behar.
No, it's pretty damn funny.
What did you think of the 3M Open?
I didn't think that much of it. The field ended up, they didn't get a good field. I was hoping for Finau, the poor son of a gun, to what 30 last 30 top tens he hasn't won, and you know the field, and then Koepka misses the cut, DJ bails after one day, Fleetwood survived right, but didn't do anything, wasn't a factor. They didn't have that many big names. You know what it did for me, Joe? It frightened me for what kind of fields they might have in the future.
Ooh.
What about the, was it Sang, Korean name, Sang Boo Bong or somebody? Yeah, did you read about the par he made on a par 5?
No, what did he do?
Second shot in the water. So that's 2 in, 3 out, hitting 4.
Yeah.
No, how did it work? He went 1.
Second in, shot in the water, so he's hitting 4. Or did he make it?
He made his 5th shot on a par 5, 253 yards hole out. It was the longest in recorded history.
Oh, wow.
I'm trying to think
for
what he
a
did.
Par, huh?
It couldn't have been 1 in, 2 out. It's a par 5. It had to be 2 in, 3 out.
Yeah, 2 in.
Hitting
he's,
4.
He, yeah, he's trying
4
to
in, 5 out, we've been hitting 6. So that doesn't work.
Yeah. Hmm.
What the hell did
he
do? He had 2 in the water and got a 5.
Well, maybe he played up next to the water in 2 and then chunked it in the water. And then hit his 5th, right? If he hit his 3rd shot in the water, then
3 in, 4 out, hitting 5.
Yeah, he must.
That
have,
must have been what it
he
is.
Must have played it up front and chunked it in the water.
Yeah, 3 in, 4 out, hitting 5, 253 yards, holds it.
Mm. You know, that very golf course is the site of perhaps the greatest putt of my life.
Oh, yeah.
Really?
Number 9, up there at the top of that green. She goes down, had to be 70 feet for a sparkling 9.
Is that where you broke that guy's ankle?
Yes, that was 16.
Wayne Levy?
Yeah, Wayne Levy. I saw 16. I turned it on the other day, and they were playing 16. I said, oh, God, I feel guilty. Don't show us this hole, please.
Right years there. Ago, local sports writer.
Right.
Yes. Or still referred to by Mr. Kavner as the crippler.
The crippler.
What a year for him, though. He started a concessions company, you know?
Oh, yeah.
They had the players. They had record crowds, right?
Yeah.
They had the greatest weekend ever, and he'd made a huge, he hadn't told me this, I got this secondhand. He made a huge investment in equipment and stuff. They shut her down. They didn't play the last 3 days. They would have had 150,000 people there in 3 days. And then he has to cancel, you know, a bunch. He had the successful tournament in Mexico. And then he had to cancel a bunch of his tournaments. And then, you know, he gets up here and they won't let him have his pro-am. You know, for a while they thought they were going to be able to have their pro-am, right, which is 2 days of making money, right, you know. They made him, the state wouldn't let him have the pro-am. Ooh. And then he doesn't get much of a field, and the guys who we've heard of don't make the cut. So it's not been a lucky year for him.
But I had not heard much about Michael Thompson, the winner.
No, last win was 7 years ago.
He has a previous win, just one.
Yeah, I didn't know much about him either. So yeah. I was rooting for Tony. I always root. You know, he seems like a good chap, and he can't finish, but
yeah.
I don't know. It's
well, your guy in the Tribune today called him a choker. Is he a choker? I don't know.
Sue Ann called him a choker. I don't know if he. I would be hard for me to refer to any golfer as a choker, but although I did see Greg Norman and I against Nick, and that was a choke. That was a choke. That was a definite choke. So.
Yep.
But Tony, I don't know.
It's just such a tough game that there's a thin line between making a mistake and choking.
Where's Tony from?
He's from Utah. He's an American citizen, but he's got what, Polynesian ethnicity background or something.
Utah has got a lot of South Pacific people. The Mormon Church did a very fine job of proselytizing out there. Yes, they did.
Well, don't quote me on Utah, but that's what I think I read.
I can look it up really quick.
I don't have internet still, so I'm going
How do you spell it? It's Finau. Is that right?
Yeah.
Okay. We're going to look it up. And he is from Salt Lake City, Joe.
I was right. All right.
Salt Lake City.
It's amazing what the mind retains.
And what it misses out on.
Can't find a pen, but I can tell you where Tony Finau's.
Well, I was just earlier today, Patrick knew the exact number of runs that Chuck Knobloch scored in 1996, and then I asked him where he parked his car.
No idea.
He knew it was outside.
I kept saying, runs, 140, right? He wouldn't confirm it. And finally, he was so embarrassed, he said, okay, you're right, it's 140.
It's 140.
140. He scored 140
Where'd
runs.
You park your car?
Right. Mm-hmm.
Well, another nice night to have a ball game that we're not going to have.
This whole week would have been spectacular.
Yeah, it was a little toasty, though, Saturday, wasn't it? Ooh.
Yeah.
Well, I guess I meant this upcoming week is supposed to be just glorious. Yeah,
that's right. Let's all get along this week, have some ball games, and, you know, stay out of the club, fellas. Stay out of the club. Even if they do have fine chicken wings, stay out of the club.
Entering the stage, she's your masked menagerie, Miss Darla, Miss Mildred.
I'm trying to remember the last time I was in one of those gentlemen clubs. I went there once but I didn't go inside, but I went there to...
For the wings?
Remember the football player, the recruit from Hutchinson who said he wasn't going to Minnesota because they lured him into the strip joint?
Yeah.
I can't remember that. What was it? Leiden Murtha, I think, was his name. And, you know, he
made the rounds?
Yeah, he ended up. And so I went in there to confirm that Leiden had been dragged into the strip club, and they were not cooperative whatsoever.
I see.
That's the last time I was in there. So that's the last time.
The last time for me was a stag party downtown, and I didn't stay. I remember my brother, my older brother, looking at me when it was the Poor's stag party, and he looked at me and said, "Don't worry, we're not doing this for yours." I was up against the wall. I'm no prude, but I was just like, "No, guys, I really don't need this."
It had to be a tough few months for the girls, though, man.
Quarantined out and. You know, you get a little rusty, you know, at that pole, and you got to
Yeah.
Social distance.
Yeah, you got to practice, you know. So what the hell? Good luck out there, ladies.
You got that guy with the special mask on.
All right, that's enough. We got to go. What do you think? We got to go.
I got to go.
Are you going to tell us where to go to get some sound financial advice?
Yes, I will right now.
He was about to put on my mask on to do the ad.
In honor of Josh, I'm going to wear a mask.
Yeah, let's hear it.
Let me see which one's Josh here.
You got her.
Mr. Money Talk, Josh Arnold. I'll bet you don't know what's in your mutual fund or your ETF.
I don't either.
Here's the worst part. I don't know what an ETF is. If you can't take my bet, then you better call my friend, Mr. Money Talk, Josh Arnold, and find out! Exclamation point. Why? Because Josh frequently
sees. See, you don't have to read the exclamation point part.
Exit.
That's like me
left.
Reading the dash. Yeah.
Your name here.
Because Josh frequently sees a common mistake with new clients.
Yeah.
In that they are allocated as high as 50% in impaired stocks. You and I know about those impaired stocks, Suchi boy.
We sure as hell do.
Every Catholic was going to buy
I swore every Catholic in the world was going to buy a Fiat.
I hope all you Catholics who didn't buy a Fiat go to hell. Yeah. Now you may be asking, what the heck is an impaired stock? I have no idea, so that is why I work with Josh.
Exactly.
Call Josh for your no-cost, no-obligation, 48-minute consultation to find out how to get the garbage out of your 401k. Or IRA. Call Josh at 952-925-5608. I almost said garage out of your 401k. Garbage was the proper word there. Call Josh, 952-925-5608.
All right.
Sounds good, bros.
Yep. Josh is not paying enough.